trying to get round the regulation all the time. And that's why, as the statute rightly says, you've got to determine whether or not the person who gets the broadcasting licence is somebody who is, quote, committed to broadcast regulation. And I am worried about it in the light of the way that Fox News conducts itself in the USA. I know you would agree, you would be the first to agree, Adam, that you would be horrified if Sky went the way of Fox News.
Well, I work for this company and I'm quite happy
with
this.
What would your view be? I'm quite happy with the company.
I think you're creating an old Sally.
We could agree, couldn't we, Adam, that you don't
you
want Sky,
crossing,
which
you,
is a...
You,
let
you
me finish the question.
You are questioning the integrity of the Times, the Sun, the Times Literary Supplement, and Sky News, by saying that there's a danger, because the people who actually took the risk, invested the money to set the company up, have backed us all these years, and you're suddenly saying that somehow they're going to have an overnight conversion to doing something different. America is a different political culture from the UK.
First of all, in relation to the newspapers, they're not governed by a broadcasting code. Secondly, in relation to
are you questioning the integrity of the Times?
Let me, integrity doesn't arrive. You can say what you like. Listen to the
you're
answer. Listen,
the integrity of the people I work for.
I'm not questioning your integrity. I respect Sky News. Listen to the answer. Don't interrupt me. First of all, in relation to the newspapers, they're not governed by a broadcast code. Secondly, in relation to what the Murdochs believe sells advertising space and make people watch, it's the Fox News type thing.
But why have they spent over £1 billion on Sky News doing what Sky News does over the past three decades?
Why have they spent all those millions on Fox News? What will happen to you if you are 100% owned by Murdochs? Let me answer. I'm the one being interviewed.
Well, you're the one who works for the company.
Yeah, all right. You're
asking me questions.
Okay. You think that it shouldn't even be investigated?
I think the regulators, like Ofcom, are there to do their job. I think they have done their job. I think the CMA is also there to do their job. I find the political attacks from the likes of Tom Watson and Ed Miliband and indeed Kenneth Clark only ill-informed and scaremongering.
They're not ill-informed. Look at the 2012 Ofcom report. James Murdoch, they described as falling well below the standards of corporate governance. He is going to become the chief... Wait, let me finish. He's going to become the chief executive officer of the company that owns Sky 100%. What's changed about James
Murdoch? The BBC forced Jimmy Savile on the British
answer
people...
Answer the question, Adam. Adam, what's the change? What's changed?
Nobody's suggesting that
Adam,
people running the BBC should
Adam,
be sacked.
Adam, what has changed? It's not a question about being sacked. It's a question of should he be allowed become your chief executive. If anybody else had the record that 21st Century Fox had in relation to corporate governance, Ofcom would never have allowed them to get broadcast.
All I can say, as you well know, James Murdoch has been chairman of Sky before.